Hey everybody, Mike B back with a redo of a video that I had posted a while back that had received a lot of negative attention from a bunch of very whiny people. A lot of Germans, native speaking Germans, who were complaining that my pronunciation wasn't 100% spot on and perfect, which I never claimed it to be. As a non-native German speaker, of course, I'm going to have an accent, right? I'm an American, and we do use different parts of our throat and mouth to speak. And it's extremely difficult to get German 100% correct. So fuck me for trying, I guess, right? I did talk to one of my German friends, and he told me not to worry about the ass clowns who were complaining and whining. And he told me that if they really were that smart, they would understand that obviously I'm not going to be able to pronounce German words 100% correctly, like a native speaker. But just like that, most Germans can't speak perfect English without an accent either. So it's the same thing. And I don't crucify them every time I hear something like that. Another difference is we don't emphasize the vowels like the Germans do. It's a habit, and it's really kind of awkward and hard for us to do. So we get it as close as we can. Basically, it's not a video about how to speak German perfect, and it's not a formal class in the language. But more of like a reference and hopefully a helpful video that will help English-speaking people be able to pronounce some German military words and terms correctly. So it sounds better and hopefully kind of preserves the German heritage and lineage that goes along with keeping the language the way it was spoken and pronounced back then when discussing such matters. It's just kind of a common courtesy thing that I thought would be welcomed by the Germans, but I guess, again, fuck me for trying. So I'm just trying to educate English-speaking people about how to stop butchering simple German words, and I'll give you some visual aids to help you out with that. First one is Luftwaffe, right? This is pronounced Luftwaffe, Luftwaffels, Luftwaffels, and it stems from the beginning problem that I'm going to be harping on quite a bit through this video is the W in German does not make a W sound like it does in English, the W, you know, water or whatever. It makes a V sound. That's why they call it they in their alphabet, right? So it's actually Luftwaffe, Luftwaffe, right? And that's as close as I can get it. All these words will be as close as I can get them. It's not perfect. I understand that. It's not like a how to speak German correctly. This is the thing. If you as an American, you don't feel comfortable using the accent or trying that out, you can actually just say like Luftwaffe or Luftwaffe. As long as you make the effort to pronounce the W as a V and not a W like we say it, Germans will be, it'll be easier for them to understand and it'll be kind of a common courtesy thing again. So, our next one, we have a really sweet visual aid. We got my 1916 DWM, or Deutsche Waffen- und Munitionsfabriken, manufactured Luger pistol, or P08, rather. Pistola 08, or 08, whatever. So, this one is called Die Waffe, right? So, it's actually, Waffen is plural, maybe Die Waffen as well. See what I did there as well. And this is really butchered a lot when I hear people talking about the Waffen SS or Wunderwaffen. Again, Luftwaffe, right? You see how this kind of is a repeating theme. It's actually Die Waffe, right? Is a singular, like weapon. And Die Waffen is plural, like the weapons, right? The weapon, the weapons. And when you're talking about the Waffen SS, it just kind of says to me that you really don't know what you're talking about, nor do you care to try to learn the correct pronunciation. It's not me being a dick, it's just how I react to that and how a lot of Germans react and how people in the historical hobbies and professions react when you say something like that and just totally butcher it. So, yeah, that's another word that I hear quite frequently butchered, all right? So that's why I brought that up. And again, that's as close as I can get it, Waffen. You know, not Waffen SS. And not Wunderwaffen, Wunderwaffen. Right? You notice the pattern? Now we've got a nice little visual aid here moving on to our next word that isn't going to be completely about the W, so you don't have to hear me harping on that for another couple minutes. But this is a World War I German Feldmütze, right? Which I'll probably do in another video following up to this. But it's green because it's a Jäger Feldmütze, or field cap. I got torn apart for this one in the last video, and yes, I was pronouncing it slightly wrong, but you can still understand what I was saying. So a J in German, just like the W doesn't make the same sound in English, a J is a Y sound, like ya. And then the A with the two dots, called an umlaut, just makes it a long A sound. So, Jaeger, Jäger, right? Because they don't pronounce the R really on the last R in German. So it'd be Jäger, like Chuck Jäger, right? But you got to figure out the R. If you say Jäger, right, like Fallschirm Jäger as an American, they'll understand you better than saying Fallschirm Jäger. You know, it's actually Fallschirm Jäger. But they'll still pronounce you, or jeez, they'll still understand you if you pronounce it like Jäger instead of Jagger. It's not Mick Jagger, even though his name, like the roots, probably came from the German word Jäger. Jäger means like hunter, literally, but in the military term, it's used as like a light infantry or skirmisher. So that's where that comes from. Sorry, I just about forgot to tell you what it meant, right? But that's another one that I see butchered quite often. And now we've got a nice hat that was, I had to strip the eagle off of it because I was selling it at a military show and they didn't allow swastikas, but now they do, so I'll have to sew it back on. So the next one is Wehrmacht, right? And this, pretty much what it is, it encompasses the entire German military. So you've got the Heer, whatever you call it, right? Two E's, H-E-E-R, which is what this hat is. The Luftwaffe. And the Kriegsmarine, right? So the SS were its own entity, paramilitary. I screwed that up in the last video. I knew that, but I just didn't mean to say that. So anyways, yeah, the SS were their own little thing. So Wehrmacht, right? It's not Wehrmacht, right? So when I hear people saying Wehrmacht, and again, it boils down to the V sound and the W, right? That's really what it boils down to, is you notice a pattern here, right? So if you can just take the, like, 2 seconds it takes to retain that information that those two letters make different sounds, it'll help you go a long way when you're trying to speak German. You don't even have to speak it perfect. Just say Wehrmacht, right? You could say that in American, like, accent like that, and people will understand you better than saying Wehrmacht, or Wehrmacht. So that's just another little thing, kind of a pet peeve, but it is what it is. So now this last one will give you some another old school piece of German iconic weaponry. And this has been butchered in a couple other notorious videos on YouTube. People calling it the goo 98, stuff like that. And yeah, I don't need to rag on that for that long. It's not just them. It's actually pronounced Gewehr, right? Or Gewehr. It's kind of a weird one, but if you say Gewehr, right, as an American speaker, they'll understand that, and it sounds better than Gewehr. Because Gewehr, it's like, what are you even talking about? I don't even know what you're saying, like what word you're trying to say. I didn't even know as an English speaker what they were trying to say, much less a German, you know? So it's like, I can't even imagine. But yeah, it's not Gewehr or Gewehr. It's again, Gewehr. And again, just put a little bit of effort into it to try and, you know, just make a little effort. I mean, you would kind of react the same way if, say, a German just didn't put any effort into any of the pronunciation at all of English words. They get kind of annoying trying to, you know, talk with them, and it's just like, really? You don't even try? Like, I don't know. Maybe it's just a personal thing where I try to learn a little bit of the pronunciation of a foreign language when I'm learning it. Kind of a respect thing. But, yeah, everybody's going to be like, oh, you just disrespected Germans in the beginning. No, I disrespected whiny Germans. They're in every culture. Germans are just really loud about it. It's part of their culture to point out everybody else's flaws, as per my German friend. That's not just my opinion. Anyway, so I'll quit rambling now. You can take a look at this Gewehr 98, or 98. But, yeah, thanks for watching, everybody. If you're new to the channel, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Also, click on the link to the Patreon in the description. For $1 a month, you keep this channel going. We do a bunch of other videos and stuff that I don't post on YouTube. I'll post on there. It's very interactive. We do giveaways and polls, and it's really fun on there. So my patrons help keep this channel going and are a big reason why I'm able to make a lot of the videos that I do. $1 a month, you can become one of those patrons. So click on the link to that. Also, if you want your own reproduction Feldmütze, it's a really high-quality one that I sell, like featured in this video, I'll post the link to that in my online shop in the description as well, right below the Patreon. So hopefully you learned something. Again, this video is not about how to speak German 100% perfect, right? That's not what the original intention was. It was just so people stop butchering it and you know a little bit more how to pronounce things so you don't sound quite as, like, ignorant to the fact. So thanks for watching. We'll see you on the next video.